How about kind of similar topic, but vacation. How does vacation look for you? Do you take vacations? I mean, it feels like you're just always going, but do you make it a point to do vacations?
Yes, for sure. I mean, I was talking to someone on our team the other day, and I met with some of our young leaders. This was a while back, but this person had remembered it. She said, from that young leaders lunch we did, and these are young leaders on our team that I wouldn't interact with on a day-to-day basis normally, but they're great people on our team and the future of our team. And so we just had this informal lunch, and I was talking about life, and they were asking questions. And I think this question came up, something similar, like the work-life balance question came up. And I said, here's the thing about me, I'm more private than the average person, especially on social media. So if you watch my social media, you think my foot is on the gas every day because it's like, oh my gosh, Louie wrote a book. Oh, look, he wrote a young reader's book. Oh, look, Louis's in London preaching at a conference. Oh, look, Louis's at a whatever meeting with three other pastors in Tokyo. And it just looks like the gas is down all the time. But what I said to the team that day was, I said, what I'm not Instagramming are all the margin around those gatherings. I'm not Instagramming, hey, I'm in Tokyo and I took 2 extra days and I'm just at this area town that I really love and is inspiring to me, and I'm just hanging out today basically with no agenda, doing what I want to do because that's what I need to do today to kind of get some more fuel in the tank. And so our lives, Shelley and myself, we've learned over time to try to be strategic, and we do realize that you just get one shot at life. So I'm not really looking for an easy life, but the pace we run at does not work if you don't put a lot of margin around the moments. And so this is a good example in pandemic. We, from, you know, that moment where we went online all the way up until the summer, really, like most leaders, hadn't been anywhere because you couldn't go anywhere. And we took 3 days and drove somewhere that was open, a place that you could stay had just opened. And then that was that, you know, and that's us several months of time with very little margin other than just every day being in the middle of it. But come to the end of the summer, we took an extended break. And coming into the fall, Shelly and I both came out of an extended break, time away, where we really did unplug for a couple of weeks. And it really breathed life into us. And that's the way we've managed to make it this far at the pace that we run at. So I want to encourage you to learn that. And when you're younger and on the front end, you don't think you need it as much because you feel invincible, but and you don't have the flexibility to put all that margin where you want it. You've got, you know, kind of like show up when you're supposed to show up. And then you kind of earn your way to a point in life where you can manage those margins a little bit different. And whichever case you're in, I just encourage people to value that and encourage leaders to value it for their people. Because if you want great people to stick around for a long time, you've got to help them figure that out.
Yeah.